Namaste students. Today I start exercise 2.3. We have done example 1. In that we have done division of two polynomials. Only we have done division of two polynomials. Now in example 2, the question is what? This polynomial is a factor of this polynomial only. So for that, you know, I have already explained you 35 divided by 5 and 5, 7, then 35. And if remainder is 0, then 5 is called factor of this 35. 7 is also called factor of 35. But here question is what? You have to only check whether this polynomial is a factor of this or not. So for that, we shall divide this polynomial pt by gt, and if we get remainder 0, then we can say that this polynomial is a factor of this. Clear? So for that, you see this first term and this first term. So what is the quotient? 2t raised to 4 upon t square. So t square cancel. So you get 2t square quotient. You divide first term by this term. So you get 2t square quotient. And 2t square into t square is 2t raised to 4. Do product of this with this. Now plus minus minus. 3 to just 6t square. 6t square minus. Plus minus minus. So 6t square is below of this. Minus 6. Don't write this as put here 0, 0, 0. Change the sign. If you put here 0 t cube, 0 t no problem. I put only 0. So this terms cancel. And now 3 t cube. 3 plus 6 minus 2. Take, consider new sign. Plus 6 minus 2 plus 4. 4t square minus 9t minus 12. Again you see degree of this first term is greater than this degree. So division is possible. So now again you see this first term and this first term. Divide 3t cube upon t square. So we get 3t plus 3t. And 3t multiplied to t square is 3t cube. 3t cube. Plus minus minus. 3, 3 is 90. 90, but it is minus 90. So here is minus. Okay? So take like terms together. And here is 0. Change the sign. You know the division, how to do division. In example 1 we have seen 4t square plus 90 and minus 90 opposite sign cancel 0 and minus 12. Again degree of this polynomial is 2 and here is 2 degrees, same degree, again division possible. But 4t square, first term you see here, divide by t square cancel, so quotient is 4, 4t square. You may directly write 4, then you will cover 4t square plus minus minus and 4 t is 12, so minus 12. And 0. Change the sign. Don't forget to change the sign. And see plus 40 square minus 40 square cancel. You get 0. 0. And 12 plus 12. New sign is plus 12 minus 12 is again 0. So I get remainder is 0. And therefore we can say that t square minus 3 is a factor of this polynomial, one of the polynomials. This is also factor of this, but we can definitely say that this t square minus 3, we have to see only this with this polynomial. answer you have to write here. Remainder is equal to 0. Therefore, GT polynomial is factor of if you don't get 0 remainder, then you have to write here remainder is not equal to 0, therefore this GT is not the factor of polynomial. Okay. So let us do second. Now polynomial is given gx is equal to x square plus 3x plus 1 and polynomial px is given 3x raised to 4 plus 5x cube minus 7x square plus 2x plus 2. So this is our polynomial px, this is gx divisor, and you have to check whether this is also factor of this or not. So divide this polynomial by x square plus 3x plus 1. Yes. See, all terms are written 4 degree 3, 2, 1, 0. They are all whole numbers. Here also in proper way they have given. So let me start the division as we have done. So here is x square. So in quotient we have to divide this first term by this first term only. 3x raised to 4 divided by x square. So x square. So 3x square is quotient. 3x square into x square, the two product of this will be this. Okay, all the time. So 3x raised to 4 plus 3 is 9x cube plus 3x square. Change the sign. Cancel. Now consider new sign 5 minus 9. Put your hand over here. 5 minus 9 is what? Minus 4. Major number is minus 9. So the sign, resultant sign is negative. Okay? And x cube. Again, minus 7 minus 3 minus 10 x cube plus 2x plus 2. Again, see, degree of this first term is greater than this. So, division is again possible. So, again, I do write this minus 4x cube upon x square. So, x square, x cube, so x minus 4x is the quotient. Now multiply this with this plus minus minus 4x cube or minus 4x cube plus minus minus. Now again minus plus minus minus 3 4 that 12x square minus 12x square minus plus minus 4 1 that 4 minus 4x. Change the sign. Opposite terms cancel. Plus 12 minus 10 plus 2x square. And both the terms are positive. So 4 plus 2, 6x plus 2. Again you see degree of divisor and degree of this first term is 2. So again both degree are same. So division is possible. If degree of this first term is less than this, then stop the division. So 2x square upon x square. So quotient is 2 and 2 multiplied to x square, that is 2x square plus 2, 3 ja 6x plus 2, 1 ja 2. Change the sign and opposite terms cancel, so 0 will get 0, 0. Clear? All terms are opposite, c plus minus, and both terms are same, like 6x minus 6, a non consider plus, new sign you consider, 2 minus 2, 0. So we get remainder 0, that means divisor is factor of this polynomial. So answer is, here remainder is equal to 0, therefore x square plus 3x plus 1 is the factor of px. Clear? In example, they have not given the name of the polynomial, but to write the answer, it is very easy that you give the name of the polynomial px and gx. So that here you have to write, instead of x square plus 3x plus 1, you may write gx also, because we have already said what is gx and what is px. Clear? So better to give the name of the polynomial. And therefore we have not to write whole this polynomial, only px. Clear? Now third one. One polynomial gx is given x square minus 3x plus 1, and px I write here so that I have not to write two times. So px, you in examination you write px equal to what and gx is what, but here I write x raised to 5 minus 4x cube. So here x cube term is there, so after 5 degree term you have to write 0 x raised to 4 xn term. If xn term, then you write 0 x raised to 4 minus 4 x cube. Then x square term is also written, x square plus 3x plus 1. Again I check x raised to 5, x raised to 4 term is xn. Minus 4x cube plus x square plus 3x plus 1, and x square minus 3x plus 1. You check two times, because if you write wrong px, then all your effort will be zero. So be careful when you write the divisor and dividend. Clear? So here we divide this polynomial by this, and let me see that 0 we get or not. If we don't get 0, then this polynomial is not factor of this polynomial. So let me start x raised to 5. Yes, what is the quotient? X raised to 5 upon x square, that means quotient is what? If you did 5, x raised to 5. So x raised to 3 multiplied to these three terms. So x cube into x square is x raised to 5 plus minus 3x raised to 4 plus 1 into x cube is x cube. Minus cancel. 3x raised to 4. Now consider new sign. Here is 1. Minus 4, minus 1, minus 5. Don't write plus 5. Clear? Minus 4 and minus number line, negative number minus, so you have to sit towards left hand side. Now plus x square plus 3x plus 1. Again, you divide first term 3x raised to 4 upon x square. get 3x square. This method you know very well. In example 1, I have already explained you. 3x square into x square is 3x raised to 4. Here, plus minus minus 3x cube. Plus 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 3x square. Change the sign. Minus 5 plus 3, 2x cube. But it is minus 5 plus 3, minus 5, number 1. Plus means you have to see right side how many? 3 digits. So minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2. So put negative sign. Minus 3, minus 3 plus 1. So minus 3, suppose here, plus means right side, plus 1. So minus 3 plus 1, minus 2. Plus 3x plus 1. See again, degree of this is greater than this. Again we shall do the division. Minus 2x cube upon x square. So we get minus 2x. So multiply minus 2x with this, then you get minus 2x cube minus minus plus 6x square. Plus minus minus 2x. Change the sign. Cancel. Minus 8x square. Plus 3 plus 2. Plus 5x. Plus 1. So again both has degree 2. Here is 2. So division is possible. Minus 8x square upon x square cancel, so minus 8. And now plus minus minus 8x square. Plus minus minus plus 24x plus minus minus 8. Change the sign, plus, minus, plus. Now 8x square, minus 8x square, plus 8x square, cancel. Plus 5, you see the only number part, see. 5, plus 5, minus 24. So 24 minus 5 is 19, minus 19x, I write here. Here? Minus 24 plus 5, so minus 24 after minus 24, 20, minus 23, minus 22, minus 21, minus 20, and minus 19. So minus 19x. Plus 1 plus 8 plus 9. So this is our Rx. So in third sum of example 2, we get remainder not equal to 0. That means this polynomial is not the factor of this. Clear? So answer write down that answer gx is not the factor of px because remainder rx is not equal to 0. Okay? So that will help to write the answer. There are total 5 sum of exercise 2.3. So example 1 and 2 both have 3 sums. I have completed example 2. Now example 3 is there. What is the question of example 3? Say that obtain all other zeros. Or all other zeros if two of its zeros are root 5 upon 3 and root minus 5 minus root 5 upon 3. All other zeros of px. Px is given 3x raised to 4 plus 6x cube minus 2x square minus 10x. minus 5. And you have said that root 5 upon 3 and minus root 5 upon 3 both are zeros of Px. First I explain this sum so that you can understand. Here see all of you degree is 4. So at the most how many zeros? 4 zeros at the most. Means there may be 4 0, 3 0, 2 0, 1 0 and no 0. But they have said us these two are the 0. Means if you put root 5 upon 3, replace x by root 5 upon 3, then you get 0. Replace x by minus root 5 upon 3, then also the value of polynomial is 0. So you have to find remaining 0, means you have to find the other zeros of this polynomial, if possible. So one thing I want to say that if root 5 upon 3 is 0 of polynomial, then factor is what? X minus root 5 upon 3 is called factor of Px. Again, another factor, X minus root minus root 5 upon 3. Now, both these are factors of Px. Now, I explain this by taking general rule. Suppose if I say alpha beta are zeros of Px. Don't write this in some, I want to explain you. Alpha beta are zeros of Px. Therefore, x minus alpha and x minus beta are called factors of Px. That you learn in standard 9. Because see, if the value of x, if you put alpha, then alpha minus alpha. So 0 into any number is 0. If you put beta here, then beta minus beta, 0. So if they say that this is our alpha and this is beta, if alpha beta are zeros of Px, then you have to write that x minus, if polynomial is in terms of x, then x minus whatever 0, that is alpha minus alpha is any number. So you put that value x minus alpha, x minus beta are called zeros of Px. This is the rule, and that's why I have written like this, that these two are 0, that means x minus alpha means root 5 over x minus beta, beta is negative, so you put in bracket. Clear? So x minus minus root upon 3 are factors of Px. So be careful when you have to write x minus alpha and x minus beta. So here Px is equal to, their factors means x minus root 5 upon 3 into x plus root 5 upon 3 these two are factors. Now you have to find another zeros. So you may say that another factor is say quotient qx. It may be quadratic, it may be linear also. So here degree of Px is 4, so there are 4 factors at the most. And two factors is decided that these two are the factors. Now find the remaining factors. Remaining factors may be maybe quadratic, whatever, and we have to further factor. So Px is equal to, now see, a minus b, a plus b, a square minus b square. So x square minus root 5 upon 3 square. Square and square root cancel, so it is 5 upon 3. I have explained you root 3 into root 3, 3. Root 5 upon 3, root 5 upon 3 is 5 upon 3 into whatever that we have to find. And therefore, our question is what to find other zero. Other zero means Qx you have to find. So Qx is equal to, yes, Qx is equal to this bracket goes in denominator of Px. So Qx is equal to Px upon x square minus 5 upon. So you have to find other zeros. For that you have to divide given polynomial by x square minus 5 upon 3. You have to divide the polynomial by polynomial. Whatever quotient you obtain, and if it is possible to factorize, then we get the answer. Okay, remaining zero we can find. Again I repeat, if these two are zeros, this alpha beta, by putting alpha beta polynomial become zero, that means which are the factor x minus. No, we have in exercise 2.2 we have done find zeros. At that time I have factorized the polynomial. And these two brackets, there are 4 degrees, so 4 brackets may be there, but 2 brackets are this. X minus alpha, x minus beta, beta is negative, so minus minus plus. These two are definitely factors. And now you have to find other factors, and I give name of, I don't know which are two factors, but I give name as Qx. Okay? So we have to find Qx. And Qx is equal to what? Px upon square term form. So product of this, I apply the formula a minus b a plus b, a square minus b square. So square of root is root cancel, half power square is c. This is half power and half power square to cancel. So you get 5 upon 3. So to get answer, I have to divide px by x square minus 5 upon 3. This topic is very important for understanding purpose. Now I rub this and I divide this polynomial by this here, and whatever quotient we get, let me see, Qx will be what? Quadratic. It is quadratic because there is 4 degree. Polynomial degree is 4. So 3x raised to 4 plus 6x cube minus 2x square minus 10x minus 5. I divide it by x square minus 5 upon 3. Same way, do division. 3x raised to 4 upon x square is 3x square. Okay, direct you may write also. Product is 3x raised to 4 plus minus minus and minus 5 upon 3 into 3x square. 3x square multiplied to this plus minus minus. 3 cancel, so you get minus 5x square. You have to write here is 0, change the sign, cancel 6x cube, 5 minus 2, 3x square, minus 10x, minus 5. See, degree of this is less than degree of this, again division is possible, so 6x cube upon x square. 6x, here you have to write 6x. 6x into x square is 6x cube plus minus 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 5 upon 3 into 6x, 3 to the 6 minus 10x, here is 0, change the sign, opposite terms cancel, you get 3x square minus 10x plus 10x cancel, minus 5. Again degree of these two same. So 3x square, so here you have to put 3x square, product is 3x square. Plus minus minus and 5 upon 3 into 3, 3 cancel, plus minus minus, minus 5. Change the sign, 0, 0. So I get remainder 0 because these two are x minus alpha, x minus beta factor. Therefore, if you divide polynomial by that product of two factors, then remainder is 0. So our qx is what? It is quadratic and this is also quad. So product of these two is whole degree or not? So adding this. So I get qx is equal to 3x squared plus 6x plus 3. Take out 3 common. So x squared plus 2x plus 1. And this is nothing but x plus 1 whole square, perfect square polynomial. So x plus 1 whole square. So remaining zeros are x plus 1. X plus 1 2 times. 3 is not 0. Okay. So at last we write x is nothing but x minus root 5 upon 3, x plus root 5 upon 3, they are the factors and qx. No, I have written here qx. Qx is nothing but 3, I put here 3, x plus 1, x plus 1 2 times, but I write here. So answer right, answer find other zeros. So other zeros are what? 3 is not 0. So other 0 minus 1. This bracket 2 times. So minus 1 minus 1. Same. So x plus 1 whole square. So I have find other zeros of these polynomials are x equal to, if you put minus 1, then minus 1 plus 1 0. So root 5 upon 3, minus root 5 upon 3, they are two zeros and other zeros are minus 1, minus 1, same zeros. So the remaining zeros are minus 1, minus 1, same zeros. So there are four degree, four zeros, they have given two already zero, alpha, beta, alpha is root 5 upon 3, beta is minus root 5 upon 3. And other zeros are minus 1 and minus 1, that I got. So method, you know now, you have given polynomial px, you have given alpha, beta, two zeros. Then how to find remaining zeros, because 4 degrees so at the most 4 zeros possible. So for that I have, what I have done, px is equal to, if alpha beta are 0, then x minus alpha, x minus beta are the factors of polynomial. And therefore if I done product of that 2, that is x square minus 5 over. And if you divide polynomial by that, then you get qx. And if you factorize qx, if you take out 3 common, if possible, then take out 3 common. And this is perfect square polynomial. Okay? So x square, square root of x square is x, square root of last term is 1, middle term you check it, 2, then you have 2x. So this is perfect square polynomial, so x plus 1 whole square. If you expand this, then you get this. So there are again 2 brackets, x plus 1. Okay, so 4 brackets, see 1, 2 and this 2 times, so 3 and 4, 4 brackets I get, and if you do product of all these, then you get these polynomials. Yeah? Clear? Don't do like that. In examination, you have to write this portion, factorize this portion and say the remaining 0, these 2 are remaining 0, so minus 1. Again, second bracket x plus 1 into x plus 1, so again minus 1. Same roots are there, remaining roots. Okay, so answer is the remaining zeros of px are minus 1 and 2. Thank you.